Hey guys, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my Invisalign journey. I am all done with Invisalign, so I figured I would do my final thoughts on it and just talk about the whole process. Before we jump into the actual video, I do want to ask you to give this video a thumbs up if you do like it, and also to subscribe to my channel for future videos. And with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the video. I want to start this video out by saying that no one has to get Invisalign or braces. Just because I got them does not mean that you should get them. I was unhappy with my teeth. They were crooked and I had an overbite, and that is why I got Invisalign. But if you're happy with your teeth, if you don't have any concerns about anything, if you're comfortable, then don't get Invisalign. You don't need to do that at all. You should be happy with your smile, and if one of the reasons you're unhappy with it is maybe that your teeth are crooked or you have some sort of a bite misalignment, then maybe this is a good option for you, but by no means is this something you have to do. The concept of Invisalign is you have these plastic trays. This is for the top jaw and this is for the bottom jaw. They're basically like a clear plastic retainer like tray, and you get a certain amount of those retainers. Each one will be moving your teeth a bit more, a bit more, a bit more, a bit more. So by the end of you wearing all of your retainers, you have a perfect smile. The more crooked your teeth are, the more retainers you're going to get, or the more trays you're going to get, so the longer this process will take. Along with trays, you're also going to have buttons on your teeth, which is something you don't really think of when you think of Invisalign. You just think of the trays that you can remove, but you also most likely will have to wear those buttons, which you do not remove. And the buttons help Invisalign stay in place and move your teeth more effectively. That's kind of the general concept of Invisalign. They're more or less invisible in your mouth. However, even if you do remove the plastic trays, you still have those buttons, which are not extremely visible, but they're not like they're not there either. So if you're looking for something that can be completely invisible, this may not be the perfect solution. Again, I don't know which teeth are going to have buttons. Maybe none of your teeth will need to have buttons, although I feel like that's pretty rare. For me, I had a bunch of buttons on both top and bottom. So when I did remove the trays, you could definitely see that I had something on my teeth, but it was fairly invisible and definitely a lot more invisible than braces. So the reason I wanted to get Invisalign in the first place is that I had both crooked teeth and an overbite. So this is what my teeth look like now after completing Invisalign. This is going to be very awkward, but bear with me. So as you can see, my teeth are straight. My overbite is fixed now as well, and if I turn to the side, you'll be able to see that my bottom jaw is meeting my top jaw. It's very awkward to model your teeth. So I guess ultimately what I want to say is that Invisalign does work. It does move your teeth. I did not have a very severe case where my teeth were all over the place, but I did have not only crooked teeth, but also an overbite as well. Invisalign took care of all of that. And not only did it fix my teeth, it also did so pretty quickly, within 7 months, in fact. But I'll talk about step-by-step procedure and what I had to go through over the past 7 months in a couple seconds, but I just wanted to go ahead and show you where I was before starting Invisalign and where I am right now. So my teeth are not perfect. They're not model material by any means, but I do want to show you guys what Invisalign can do to your teeth. I had Invisalign for 7 months and I had 14 trays. That was my Invisalign treatment. Again, depending on how crooked your teeth are, how much they need to move, your tray number will vary. So you might have less trays, you might have more trays. My mom did Invisalign as well, and she had more trays, I believe. I think she must have had like 20 trays or something like that. So I had a little bit less, but it just depends on your personal teeth and personal smile. All right, so the first procedure is getting molds. You go into your doctor's office and they take molds and then they send those into Invisalign. So that is before anything happens with Invisalign. That is the first step that you have to go through. The second appointment will be about 2 weeks after the first one. That was the case for me. That's how long Invisalign took. And there you're going to find out how many trays you're going to have and how long the process is going to take. Your doctor will have your Invisalign trays ready and you're going to get those buttons on your teeth. Essentially, the fewer buttons, the better for the appearance because buttons are visible. They also discolor over time with food and drinks, and you can't really whiten them. But ultimately, you do want Invisalign to work, so just, you know, you're gonna have to deal with some buttons for a couple months, and that's just unfortunately the case here with Invisalign. One of my buttons came off twice during 7 months, so I had to come back and reattach it. So if it happens to you, don't panic. You're just gonna have to call your dentist and they're gonna have to reattach the button. Don't worry about it, because the first time it happened to me, I kind of freaked out. Okay, so now let's talk about the trays, because you're gonna have to be wearing the trays, and that's the main bulk of the Invisalign treatment is the trays. So like I said, I had 14 trays. I had to wear a new tray every 2 weeks. Every new tray comes in a little packet, and the packet will have the date of when that tray is supposed to be place in your mouth. So just a reminder if you forget, like, when you're supposed to pop that new tray in. The first time I put a tray in, I could barely speak. I had a horrible lisp, and the lisp did not go away quickly. I feel like everybody was saying that, oh my god, the lisp will go away in like a day. That was not the case for me. I had it for a good while, and honestly, I still can't speak with Invisalign properly. It's not a huge deal. Lisp is a lisp. You can still convey your message even if you have it, but just a heads up, it's something I did not expect at all. When I first put it on, I was like, what is this? Am I gonna speak like this for the next 7 months? You will learn how to speak with them in your mouth. It's just gonna take time, and it's probably gonna take longer than people say it will. At least that was the case for me. Also, the first tray hurt the worst, but the pain will go away. For me, it went away after 2-3 days. I found that with every new tray, the pain was less and less and less. So the second tray, the pain was mild, but definitely more bearable than the first tray. And then every tray after that, the pain was just very, very small. And also, if you don't wear your trays for a couple hours, when you put them on again, it might hurt for a bit. But in that case, for me, the pain would go away after 30, 40 minutes. It wouldn't last for a long time. But again, because your teeth are moving, they don't like that. You will have some pain, and when I say pain, it feels like it's more of a dull pain, but it's definitely uncomfortable, but it's bearable. As far as cleaning the trays, every morning after I wake up, I put my trays in a vinegar for, I don't know, 10 minutes, and then I rinse them out. That's how I clean my retainers. I don't know if there's a better way, but that's kind of the way that I googled, I found, and it really worked well for me. Vinegar is inexpensive, and I found that my trays stayed clean. That's how I clean them. I do recommend you clean your trays at least once a day, maybe even twice a day if you need to, just because, I mean, you're putting this in your mouth. It's in your mouth for all the time. And yes, you do get a new tray every 2 weeks, which is nice. They don't get that dirty over that time, but it's better to clean them at least once in a 24-hour period. As far as what you need to carry with you, every time you eat, you take your trays off, you eat, and then you have to brush your teeth and floss your teeth. I know that sounds like a lot of work, and it is, but it's something you're gonna have to deal with for a couple months while you have Invisalign on. If you have cavity-prone teeth, this is especially important, but really it's important for anybody, because if you don't brush and floss your teeth before putting the trays back on, you're gonna get cavities, and nobody likes cavities. Maybe the dentist, but even they don't really want you to have cavities. Just make sure you brush and floss your teeth. If you want to see what kind of contraptions I carried in my purse, I will link the first video I did when I just got Invisalign. But you basically need a toothbrush. You can get a foldable travel size toothbrush, or if you want, you can just carry a regular toothbrush. It doesn't really matter. Anything that you brush your teeth with will work. Also, you'll need toothpaste and some floss. If you don't have any option to brush your teeth or floss your teeth, chewing gum may help to get rid of some of that buildup, but that would be the last resort. I would recommend brushing your teeth if you can, but at the very least, at least chew some gum. Also, one thing nobody ever mentions when they talk about Invisalign is teeth drilling. That sounds bad, let me explain. If you have overcrowding and your teeth need to move somewhere, but there's no space for them to move there, your dentist may need to drill small little gaps between your teeth. Now, some people may not need to have any drilling done. My mom didn't, but I had overcrowding. I still have my wisdom teeth in, maybe that's why, and he did have to drill in certain places. Again, it sounds worse than it is. I did not have to get numbed up for this, so it does not hurt. It's a very, very small amount, and Invisalign tells you where to drill. So it's coming from Invisalign. It's not your dentist being like, I just feel like drilling some teeth. It's actually Invisalign telling your dentist that your teeth need to move there, but there's no space for them. So the only way you can move them is if you have a little space. When you are done with all of your trays and your teeth are nice and straight and you're happy with a smile, the dentist will make sure that everything is in the right place. You are going to need to take the buttons off. That's kind of almost the last step. Taking off buttons can be quite tricky because the materials that they use for the buttons is supposed to match your teeth. So the dentist doesn't exactly know necessarily where the button ends and where the tooth starts. Sometimes it's visible, sometimes it's not so visible because the material that they use for the buttons blends in so well. Taking off buttons is painless and it does not take a long time, but you do want to make sure that, you know, if you feel like there is a bit of a growth on one of your teeth where the button was before, that you tell your dentist to maybe look at that area and make sure that the button is fully off. After you are done with your buttons, now it's going to be time to figure out what kind of retainer you want and potentially take molds of your teeth to make a retainer. I am doing a clear retainer, the same kind of a concept as Invisalign. It's a plastic retainer that goes over your mouth, except it's going to be a harder material, so it will last for a long time. So while the retainer is being made, you're going to need to wear something in the meantime. Maybe your dentist will give you a temporary retainer, or you may also need to wear your last Invisalign set as your retainer without buttons for the time that your new retainer will be made, if that makes any sense. So essentially your Invisalign will act as a temporary retainer, except you're not gonna have buttons on, but your teeth are already moved in the position that they need to be. You're just trying to basically keep them there. And from that point on, you're going to have to wear your retainer for pretty much the rest of your life, as far as I understand, because your teeth can move. In the beginning, you're probably gonna have to wear your retainer like you wore your Invisalign 24/7, or, you know, as much as you can. And afterwards, you will be able to switch to wearing your retainer just at night. But your dentist will have to kind of tell you when that switch will have to happen, unless your dentist tells you you can just wear your retainer at night only. But you're gonna have to wear a retainer regardless of when for pretty much the rest of your life, as far as I understand, because your teeth can move. It's not a matter of wearing your retainer for just a year and then be done with it. You're gonna have to wear it for a long, 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 long time. The good news is that the longer you wear your retainer, the less often you have to wear it, as far as I understand. So 10 years down the line, you may only need to wear your retainer a couple nights a week, and that's it. So that's the good news here. That's the silver lining. So ultimately, I do think that Invisalign is worth it. You can look, for the most part, braceless with Invisalign, and I really like that aspect of it. However, Invisalign is more expensive than regular braces, so you have to pay for that braceless almost look. As far as the money is concerned, do make sure that when you call your dentist to ask how much Invisalign costs, make sure that the cost of the retainer is included in the cost of Invisalign. So when you're calling them, just ask, is the retainer included, and if not, how much does the retainer cost on top of the Invisalign? So just kind of heads up there, because my retainer was not included and I just didn't know that right off the bat. So just a heads up as we're talking about the price thing. I was saving up money to get Invisalign for a while now, and I am very happy with my decision to invest in my teeth, and it was definitely worth it for me. It wasn't so bad, honestly, wearing Invisalign and having buttons, and a small part of me will miss it, I think. A very small part, but it will miss it. I know maybe not all of you are, you know, looking to get Invisalign, but I just wanted to talk about how the experience went if you're curious, because I never really understood or knew about the nuances of Invisalign, but that was my experience with it. So thanks so much for watching my video. I hope this was helpful. I hope to see you in the next video, and have an awesome day. Bye.